Hello and welcome to Comic Island. My name is Arden, and these are my thoughts and feelings on the Logan trailer. So this dropped and really made some waves in the world, didn't it? People from the outside world who don't follow comics day to day were talking about it and bringing it up with me. Everyone's gotten pretty excited about it, and on the whole, it's pretty much the exact opposite situation of that horrible Ghostbusters trailer. That's neat. Here on Comic Island, we've noticed a small but meaningful bump in activity with my Old Man Logan video, and thus I've decided it's actually probably worth going about making another video about all of this. I don't normally like doing these. By now, YouTube is no doubt cluttered with every single silly commentator and personality giving their thoughts and reacting to this thing. Yet I think I can actually offer something a little different. If you haven't seen my video on Old Man Logan, you should check it out. It's a very early rendition of our complete stories, but one of the more epic tales I've taken on, and has something of a special place in my memory. There's also the Secret Wars tie-in and the follow-up current series, both of which I've also made some videos on. And I say this not to plug my own work, although, you know, those links will all be in the video description below, but to point out that I really have a handle on this guy and his story. So my perspective on the movie and trailer might offer something others don't. Potentially. That's the thing about trailers, they don't really tell you much. I really don't have any extra information that others couldn't get themselves. I can tell you it's a well-made trailer. One where the use of Cash's version of Hurt just fits so perfectly with the tone of the trailer, and hopefully the movie as a whole, that it's just solid advertising overall. Yet that's all it really is, a promising trailer. My personal reaction on seeing it is that yes, this does look awesome, and it might just be the best Wolverine movie yet. This isn't a franchise with the best track record. X-Men Origins Wolverine is a special kind of garbage. While the Wolverine I do like, I think it's a decent action movie, but yeah, it does get boring at times, and definitely suffers from crummy effects. So the bar isn't really all that high for Logan to begin with. Even then, if this movie is half as good as that trailer, well, suffice to say, I am at this point pretty interested in the whole thing. I get the impression that it's going to kind of be like The Wolverine, a more mellow action piece, toned down in comparison to the other X-Men movies, but as a result, more tightly managed and polished. At least that's what I'm kind of hoping for. The additional fact that Patrick Stewart is in it, well, that just might be the most exciting part of this movie. And yeah, the timeline's all weird now, but that's not important, that's not what really matters. I like James McAvoy as Professor X, I also like Patrick Stewart as Professor X. If they can somehow get away with using both, I am totally okay with that, even though it makes no sense. That being said, Logan is probably going to be a little slow at times, it might even get boring. There's no way it will be the same over-the-top insanity that is the original comic. We just can rule that out right now by the sheer number of characters Fox isn't allowed to use. The Red Skull, the Hulks, Hawkeye, Captain America, Iron Man, Thor, Giant Man, Venom, Mysterio. All these big, cool parts and set pieces of Old Man Logan that cannot see the light of day in this movie. I don't even think Fox would be up for the Doctor Doom cameo. I wouldn't count on any dinosaurs showing up anytime soon. Is that disappointing? Kind of. It doesn't mean Logan will be bad. It does mean it will be different, because it has to be. And as much as I would love to see half of the craziness we get in Old Man Logan, like I really want to see a Venom dinosaur in action one day, I kind of prefer that the writers, director, and Hugh Jackman craft their own story instead. Let their creativity flourish and things should work out. So yeah, I expect a story on a much smaller scale, with a tighter focus on Logan and the loss he's experienced in the distant past. That should work for a good, albeit very grim, movie. Throw in some of the expected Wolverine-flavored ultra-violence and we should have something worth seeing, even if it will be wildly different from the source material. Perhaps it will be great because of that, because this movie will have to carve out its own identity. It's also going to be interesting seeing how this takes place within the larger X-Men universe now that they're really starting to roll this thing out. My guess is it's going to take place in the distant future, what with an older Logan, him having a family, Patrick Stewart. But I also suspect there's going to be some sort of meaningful tie to the current X-Men movies. Maybe there'll be some time travel involved, or who knows what will happen. Whatever the case, we'll know how it all turns out when we see it. For now, I remain cautiously optimistic. No need to get hyped or set ourselves up for disappointment. It could be great, it could be decent, it could be bad. With Fox's comic movies, you never really know until you get there. So thanks for watching, and let me know what you think in the comment section below. If you like this video, be sure to check out our new Patreon page. Patreon supporters get all sorts of cool benefits and perks, so be sure to give it a look and consider supporting Comic Island. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and keep reading comics.